Hi everyone, my name is Harjot Singh and our company is Lark Engineering Company India, based in Haryana, Yamunanagar, city near to Chandigarh. And I'm working as a business head in sales and marketing in Lark Engineering Company. We specialize in design and manufacturing of feed machines in poultry, cattle and aqua division. We are into this market since 1994 and we have more than 4,500 installations in India and abroad. This time in poultry event, we demonstrated our few products like this is our 60 TPH pellet mill die, especially we produce for the Sugna Foods Hoskote plant, and this is our 10 TPH fully automatic feed mill model. Here is a small feed mill, 3 TPH. Even a broiler farmer having 2 or 2.5 lakhs of birds, they can produce their own feeds, crumbs. And that is our 15 to 20 TPH hammer mill model. We have patenting technology in this hammer mill machines. Few farmers visited our stall yesterday and they requested us to explain the 10 TPH, this bigger model, this one, so that they can have a quite good understanding of the complete feed mill process. So we start from this intake batching point. This is a model of a 10 TPH feed mill. And the first part is the batching. In batching, we have to put the grains in the dosing bins with the help of that chain conveyor and dumping points. These are different dumping points. This one, the grain near to the respective dumping points, supervisor puts into the dumping points, and this chain conveyor, with the help of this intake elevator, conveys the material to the top. Then there is a magnet filtration system that filter all the iron impurities from the grains. Then after the magnet filtration system, there is a drum sieve or jute remover that filters the jutes from the gunny bags. Then there is the rotary distributor that guides the material to the respective dosing bins. We as a feed machines manufacturer, we are the first company in India to introduce the rotary distributor in feed mills, because most of the feed mill suppliers uses drag chain conveyors with the more power consumption and the more maintenance. But this is just point, with the help of 0.5 HP motor, this rotary distributor guides the material to the respective dosing bins. These are the dosing bins for the maize, soya DOC, rice, broken rice, MBM, gluten, millet, grains as per the formulation. Every feed miller can have a requirement of the different dosing bins with respective to the capacity and the number of bins. Then after the dosing bins, there is a weigh hopper with the load cells. A PLC operator just selects the recipe and number of batches with the help of the screw feeders and the gravity feeders. Screw feeders we use for the fibrous materials and the gravity feeders for the free flowing material. With the help of the screw and the gravity feeders, the whole batch comes to that weigh hopper. This completes the batching process. Then the second process is the grinding. Here we can see, after the batching, the whole batch with the help of this grinder elevator goes to the hammer mill. There is also a additional magnet system of the hammer mill to filter the iron impurities. The purpose of the hammer mill is to reduce the particle size so that we can achieve good conditioning, good pelleting, and there is better gelatinization in the conditioning process. So there is a rotary feeder above the hammer mill that controls the feeding with respect to the amperes of the hammer mill. Then after the size reduction in the hammer mill, the next process is the mixing process. Here we can see, after the hammer mill, there is also one extra dumping hopper From this hopper, we can add the non-grindable materials that we want to bypass the hammer mill directly to the hopper of the mixer. Then this is the mixing section. The purpose of the mixing section is to get the homogeneous feed, because a diet of a bird is around 80 to 120 grams. In that dose, we need all the nutrients, vitamins, minerals, elements, all the things in a complete dose. So the purpose of mixer is to produce a homogeneous mixed feed. We claim this is our patented design of double ribbon technology. We claim CV less than 7 in premix addition, and we also have a double shaft mixer with CV less than 3 with just mixing time of around 180 seconds. Here in the mixer we add the additional oil and the medicines. So this completes the mixing section. Then after the mixing section, there is a, this is pelleting section. These are the three conditioners from where we add the steam for the moisture addition, for the heat, and for the gelatinization of the ingredients for a better digestibility and good FCR. Then after conditioners, the temperature goes around 80 to 85 degree as per the process, as per the grains, and as per the formulation. And the moisture goes around 13 to 14.5%, or even in some cases 15%. Then the feed comes to this pellet mill. So with the help of the die and rollers, the rollers pushes the mesh feed to the pellet die, where the all the powders, the moisture feed, the all the powders converted to the granules. Then we have to cool the feed for the packing and the storage purpose. So there is the, we requires immediate cooling after the pelleting. This is the cooler. With the help of the blower and the cyclone, the cooling process, we cools down the temperature of the feed to the temperature near the ambient temperature of the room, with plus around difference of 5 degrees centigrade. And the moisture we reduce as per the season. For example, in rainy season, we keep the lesser moisture around 11 or below 11, and in summer, maybe 11.5 and 11.8, as per the process and as per the requirement of the company and as per the shelf life required for the feed. Then there is a crumbling. After cooling, this is the crumbler, crumbling process. A day old chick, a small chicks unable to pick the big pellet size. So for that, we have to crush the granules of the pellet, so that a small day-old chick can easily pick the particle. So in this is the crumbling process. During crumbling process, there is some dust formation. To filter that dust and to produce a good quality feed, we filter all the dust in that screeners. There are the screener at the top floor that filter all the fines. Fines goes for the repelleting, and the finished goods goes to the bagging bin. Then after the screening process, there is a auto bagging machine. As per the formulation, as per the texture, as per the, for example, for mesh feed we have a different design auto bagging machine. For the crumbs or pellet, we have a different design auto bagging machines. So after the auto bagging, we can pack the bag in the size suitable for the feed industry. Most of the companies use 50 kgs, and for the self-consumption or integration, some use even 70 kg bag. Then with the branding and the batch date and the expiry and all the things, we can pack the bag and keep in our storage, go down, finished good storage. And as per the moisture and as per the formulation, we can store the bag for a few days, then can supply to the respective farms or all other things. For more details, you can contact our company. We have the complete detail of the process parameters. Even we do the feed mill audits. And if there is any requirement regarding the feed mill, the process, and all the production parameters, you can contact our company. Our company is Lark Engineering. Our website is www.larkengco.com. And that's all for the feed mill process. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Yes.